Welcome to Sevalla Crash Course. As you know, I'm always looking for alternatives to Vercel and Supabase, and this one Sevalla reached me out. Sevalla has everything in one dashboard: application, database, and storage for less than $20 a month. And the best part is you don't have to set anything, you just can deploy everything in one click. And now it's giving you $50 credit so you can try it for free. So this is the dashboard of Sevalla. I've been testing it for 2 weeks, so you see already like I've been using a lot to do this tutorial. In the dashboard is all that we want. We have application, we have object storage, we have database all in one, as I say, super easy. So I will use for this tutorial my project PeerQuick. As you know, I'm not using Hello World tutorial, so I use real project. So this is my B2C, B2B SaaS boilerplate, in case you don't know. And it's not a very big project, but we'll show you here in Visual Studio Code. It's a decent project already to use it for this tutorial. So let's go. First, go to dashboard, add service on the right corner, application. So when we create an application, we have two options: a Git repository or Docker image. Docker image is the same thing that we did with the VPS and Qualify. So this is like the most complicated things. So for these tutorials, I will just straight away to connect to my GitHub and do it automatically through Sevalla, because we do something easier here. So we want that, right? So in the first time that you log in on Sevalla, in here, instead like having straight away to connect your repository, you will have a button to connect to your GitHub. Just click it and we'll connect straight away, very easy. And then in here you need to click if you need a private repository or public repository, and then you just connect to your repository, and that's it. Then you can choose your branch, you can write down the name that you want, and also you need to use the location. For this tutorial I will leave West Europe, it's fine for me, but you can change the one that you need. And for resources, the first plan is $5 a month, so it's very cheap and affordable, but I will use this standard one, the first standard, the 1 GB RAM, which is $10. That one is the first one that you can connect your own domain, okay? So then you can create and deploy, or you can just create and then deploy. I rather create and then deploy in case there is some error or something. So then you can go on the left and choose deployment, and on deployments just click on deploy now. So it's that easy. Just we have main by default and deploy application. So this will take a few minutes, couple, something like that. As I say, after 2 minutes more or less, the deployment is done. It has been successful, so very simple, very easy. And now I want to show you, I'm going to click here on deployment, and I'm just going to show you how these things work. Okay, so we did with this pack. And the NIST pack is just doing everything automatic, so you don't have to add anything to your code, or you don't have to do anything extra. We also have build packs here, and we have Dockerfile build packs as well. If you're using Heroku, I believe it's the fastest way to do it, and also it's doing automatically. And Dockerfile, you need to add your Dockerfile to your code actually. So this is the one that is not very straightforward. Anyway, if you have it from the VPS or something and you want to use it on that way, you know that Docker, I'm very fan of Docker, and you have more control about that. And here you see all your build resources, so you can change it anytime and deploy in a different way. On the settings, we have everything related as well to Git repository and your GitHub, and also you can set automatic your deployments as well. I'm not gonna do that because I want to deploy it myself anytime that I change something, but you can do it. And you have the danger zone as well to delete everything that you need, okay? And here as well, you have this not being by default. So after you change it for your right one, this is the one that you can see that here we go. Our application is here, is live. And after that, we will change for our domain, our custom domain. But that I will show you at the end, okay? Now, what we have to do is add our environment variables. I will just do it in one, so I will add a file with all of them, but you also can upload them one by one. The panel for the environment variables is very, very nice and very easy. And after that, you need to do another deployment, okay? So just remember, because otherwise they're not gonna work. Then here on the left panel, we have analytics and we have another things, but I want to show you the logs, because just in case your project deployment is failing, this is the is where you can check everything here. But in my case, as you see, everything weren't successful, so not much to check. And yeah, we have here everything. And then on deployment, I forgot to tell you, but if you click straight away to visit app, it's the fastest way to check your deployment. And then you have these three dots, and in here says redeploy. So you just click, and it's the fastest way if you want to redeploy your app. Analytics here are very clear for database, for application, that in Vercel and Supabase, for me, always they are very confusing. So now we're gonna add a storage. So for the storage, we have two options, same like for everything here on Sevalla. So we can go on the main dashboard, add service, and choose storage, or we can go on object storage here on the left side and click here, and then we can add object storage here on the right side on the top. As you see, object storage costs 2 cents for gigabyte, so a month, so it's super cheap, probably. And then you need to choose a display name and also an location, okay? So for my case, I will use the same location like my application, which is Western Europe. You can choose the one that you need. And yeah, create button. Here we go. We saw here our storage. And in here, you will push the object that you need, photos or whatever you need, or also you can upload it. You will see how I do it for this tutorial. So in my case, for PeerQuick, I will upload my boilerplate zips here, and then I will be using them to send it by email every time that I got a sale. And in here you have also user management in case you need to invite some user. I'm not gonna use this one. And here you have all these settings. So basically you have all your backend's name, endpoints, access key, secret keys. So it's what we need and what we're gonna use for our code. Ah, also you can make it public. I'm not gonna make this storage public because it's just for myself. And also in here you can delete the storage in case you need. So as I say, we're gonna copy all keys, endpoints, everything, and we're gonna use this one in our code. So we will paste it here on our .env file. And now what I'm gonna do is implement it here on my webhook. And then I will explain you a little bit more about what I was doing. So I create a new client, Sevalla client here, and this way I add the endpoint, access keys, and secret key, as I say. And this also you need to add here the packet name. And in here you see the URL that I told you that is for downloading. So in here I call my Sevalla client, and this is how my user will download the boilerplate. In here I just write my email to test it. So to test, what I'm going to do is just using the Stripe CLI. So I will trigger a checkout session. So I'm doing this very fast. If you haven't heard about this one, just check it out. So it's very worthy for payment and checkout session. You have all the logs So here we go. We have our email. Everything went successful. If I click here on the download button, also it's downloading, so everything went well. I've been testing this one as well in Be Underwater, because in Be Underwater, as you know, the dive center can upload photos to the app. So this is a different way to do it. Instead, like we uploaded by ourselves on the dashboard, this is just made everything on a post route. So I was thinking like this is maybe interested and maybe it's the way that you will use the storage. So in here you see like I create a client similar like this one, then I create the post route, and then what I do is just pushing these photos to the bucket. I doing some checks like if we have a photo, just delete it before pushing the new one, so I don't collapse my storage and have 100 or 1,000 photos that nobody used them. So it's what this route is doing. So in case you need the code or something and you wanna through all this, just let me know and I happy to share this with you. I mostly use AI as well to help myself with this, so also you can do that if you want. Also, you can use Sevalla docs. Sevalla docs are great, seriously. They are like super well explained. We always forgot about that and now we always check online, but sometimes the key is on the documentation. Now let's go to create a database. So saying we go to the dashboard, on the add service button we can add a new database, or we can go to the left side and click on database and create a new one. I will be creating a PostgreSQL database as usual. I will just change the name to PeerQuick database. And for this tutorial, I'm not gonna change the user, but you can call admin or whatever you want. And also in here, you can change your database password, that I don't gonna do it either. And then location, same thing. So you can choose your locations. And for the resources, the minimum plan for the database is that one, that is 1 gigabyte, and it's $5 a month. So it's as well very affordable, because we have $10 plus $5, so plus the storage, so the cost is gonna be maximum per month like around $20 or something like that. So it's everything one click and super cheap. In here the status is creating, so it's gonna take a few minutes. So here we go. After a few minutes you see the status is ready, and in here we have our connections. So we have host, we have port, we have a database, we have user, password, and the full URL, okay? So we have internal connection and external connection, and I don't know why, when I was testing before this tutorial, the internal connection never worked for me. So I will use the external connection for this tutorial, but if you just want to keep it a little bit safer, just keep internal better. You can connect here as well your app to the database. So I will connect here to my application PeerQuick, and in here as well you have your password management, so you can change your password anytime. So this is very simple. If you use Prisma as I do, you just need to take this full URL at the bottom, and then here you see on my Prisma schema. So just have here on the top my database URL. So it's very simple. You just need to go to your .m and you can create a new variable called database underscore URL and paste the full URL from Sevalla. And that's all. So now we need to start our database. So we just need to write these two commands in case you use Prisma. And with these two commands, the generate and migrate our database, just will start and will be ready to use. Now, I'm going to check on PeerQuick if everything works properly. So I will create a new user. So here we go, here is registered, so everything is okay. And now I will try to log in as well. We are logging, everything works. On your database, we have here the studio. So the studio is amazing. It's just amazing because we have everything here, and yeah, it's great. So in here we see our user, the one that we create and is working here. So this is also the worry that I have, like maybe we don't have this studio, and because I really love this dashboard. Anyway, you can use the Prisma Studio, but this one, I really like it. Here we have settings as well, so you can add record from here. Just if you need to change something, you can change it and save it. So it's perfect. It's super easy, super nice. And then also I want to show you as well here the analytics. So the analytics here are very clear for database, for application. In Vercel and Supabase, for me always they are very confused. In here you have everything. And then also this is the great. This is one of the important parts. In here we have daily backups. Sevalla is doing daily backups of your database. So you don't need to worry, you need to add extra storage for your backups. You don't need to do anything else. Just Sevalla is doing everything for you. So it's doing daily backup, as you see here on the documentation. This has been stored for 7 days, and then you also can create 5 manuals here. And then you need to click here to restore, and yeah, then it will automatically restore. Yes, I miss that I don't see these backups, but I like to see what they save, and I like to see what I have in my backups. But still, it's great. It's yes, they do everything for you, and you don't need to worry about that. And in here you have also the user management, so you can invite the users. I'm not gonna use this one. And settings, as I said, on application and storage as well, that you have here your details. You can always edit them, suspend your database, or delete your database. The last thing we have to do, as I say, is just adding our custom domain. So for that you need to go to your applications, and then you need to go to domains, add a custom domain, and add the name of your domain. And then you will have these 2 DNS records that you need to add to your domain provider. So in my case it's Namecheap, and in here on the documentation you see that you need to use the source name for the DNS record, otherwise it's not gonna work, because that happened to me. And also be patient, like wait around 10-15 minutes until this works. Okay, in my case was taking a little bit longer. And also you have this tools like MS Toolbox to check it out if the DNS is working or no, you did something wrong. This is the last record that you need to add to your domain provider, and with that everything is complete. So now we can check it out, and here we go. This is working very quick. It's up. I hope you like this video and enjoy Sevalla in the same way that I do. It's not because it's sponsored, it's just a great platform, super clean, super cheap, and everything together. So if you have any question or comment, just drop it below and I will reply. And also if you like this kind of videos, just subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.